everyone. I'm Johnny Carson. And welcome to The Tonight Show. Yes. We've got a fantastic time for you tonight, taking you back to the 70s. This is going to be really fun. We have special guest Steve Martin on the show tonight. Wild and crazy guy. And, have you read the news today? Anybody read the news? They just said today, you know, Christmas is coming up soon. It's not too far off. And they just said today that they're not going to have a nativity scene this year on the White House lawn. No nativity scene. It's not because of religious reasons. They just couldn't find three wise men in Washington. So. I did not know that. And right now we'd like to bring out that magical, mystical from the Far East. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Karnak the Magnificent. All right. I have right here an envelope that's been hermetically sealed and left in a mayonnaise jar until noon today. No one knows the contents of this envelope. I will ascertain the answers without even knowing the question. Sisk boom ba.
Sisk boom ba.
Describe the sound a sheep make when it explodes. I did not know that. Hurry up. Name a drink that's made with 7-Up and prune juice. Zippity doodah. Zippity-doo-dah. How I tell Ed McMahon his doodah is open. You may kiss the bride. Name the 5 most expensive words in the English language. And I hold right here the final envelope. Clippity-clop, bang-bang, clippity-clippity-clop, bang-bang-bang. Describe an Amish drive-by shooting. We'll be right back after this message with Steve Martin.
Discover Fanta brand flavors.
Steve Martin is a comedy writer whose credits include The Sonny and Cher Show, The Smothers Brothers. He made his first appearance on The Tonight Show some weeks back as a magician. He's back tonight to do something else, and I don't have the slightest idea what it is. But we'll find out. Would you welcome, please, Steve Martin.
Hello, I'm Steve Martin. I'll be out here in a minute. It's so great to be here tonight. This is a great show here at The Tonight Show here. Here we go. Let's not waste any more time. I'm a rambling guy. Well, I'm rambling, rambling round. I'm a rambling guy. Rambling down here in Branson, Missouri. I've studied a lot about Missouri, and it's great to be here in the capital of Missouri. Well, this is the opening song. It's not very long. The end. And what if I were to change keys in the opening song? Wouldn't that be exciting? No. All right, now it's sing-along here on The Tonight Show. But you can sing any song you want. So everyone, pick out a song. I'll pick one out. Hold on, let me pick one out. Okay, on three. One, two, three. To dream the impossible dream. Good. Now, this half of the room, any song you want. Let me pick one out. Okay, on three. One, two, three, everybody. Mule train, yeah. Clippity-clop, hippity-hoppy along the train. Mule train. Okay, now, that guy. Good. In Chinese now. Well, I'm rambling, 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 rambling. Yeah. Look, if you expected a little intellectual humor out here tonight, well, excuse me. Thank you. Good night, everybody. Thank you.
Now it's time for one thing more, to taste the taste worth shopping for. Hey, Chick-fil-A today, Chick-fil-A.
Connor's got a new job, assistant principal.
It's the Carol Burnett Show.
Mrs. Awakens, could you come in here for a moment here? Okay, Mrs. Awakens, I just got this new intercom system put in here. Now, the way this works, I can just press this button and you can whiz right on over here. And now you've got one and I've got one, and this, the way this operates is, you press the button when you need to talk, and you talk. And if you're listening, you just listen. Now, you think that you got that there?
Sure.
Okay. Well, just run along now. That'll be good. Not the brightest bulb in the knife drawer. All right. Mrs. Awakens, I was wondering if you could come in here right now. I'd like to dictate a letter to you. Mrs. Awakens, I was wondering if you
Hello?
Could come... Mrs. Awakens, I was wondering
Hello?
If...
Hello?
Mrs. Wiggins, don't press the button when I'm talking
Hello?
To you.
Hello?
Mrs. Wiggins, we don't
Hello?
Press
Hello?
The button.
Hello? Hello?
Mrs. Wiggins, could you come in here right now and help me out here? person I know who could tailgate herself. Okay. Mr. Delmar, in regards to your letter on the 25th, I feel that a written reply is in keeping with the company policy. And rather than seeing you in person, I'm forwarding you this letter. And if you... Mrs. Wiggins, are you going to memorize this?
Oh, I wasn't aware you were giving me dictation.
Well, I said it on the intercom system.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
Well, I did say it.
I guess I should get my pad now.
That would be a good idea.
I guess I'll get my pad now.
That's even a better idea.
I'll go get it right now.
That's a novel idea, pointing to the places she already been.
Yeah. Let me check. There's a Mr. Delmar on the phone. Would you like to talk to him?
No, I don't want to talk
Hello?
To Mr. Delmar. No, I don't want
Hello?
To talk to Mr.
Hello?
Don't press the button when I'm
Hello?
Talking to you, right?
Hello? Hello?
I don't want to talk to him right now.
He's not here right now, bye.
Mrs. Wiggins, could you come in here now?
Hello?
I'd like to dictate the
hello?
Letter to you right now.
Hello, hello.
Come in here real quick. I'm coming.
Hello, hello, hello.
Mrs. Wiggins, come in here and I want to show you something real quick. Let me get this right here. Come on, Jiffy, quick. Wait for the sonic boom. This is getting almost comical. I'm beginning to laugh to myself right here. Now, I'm going to explain this to you one more time. These are the two intercom systems. You talk to them back and forth, like this here. Hello, Mrs. Wiggins. How are you today? Pretty good. How about yourself? Oh, I'm pretty good, but my knee hurts. Well, why don't you go home and soak it? That's a good idea. I'll probably do that later. Now, you see how that works right there?
Yeah, sure.
Now, you tried to say something.
Can you hear me?
Okay, now here's what we're going to do. Come over here and sit in my chair.
What?
You sit in this chair right here. I'm going to go in there, and I'll be you. You be me, okay? I'll show you how this works here, okay?
I'm you. You're me.
That's a great idea. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, here we go.
Yes, Mrs. Wiggins?
I've got a real important phone call, Mr. Tudball.
Who is it?
What do you mean, who is it?
How can I know it's an important phone call unless I know who it is. Mrs. Wiggins.
There's no one to ask.
Mrs. Wiggins, by golly, how many times do I got to tell you to find out who it is before you buzz me on this doggone intercom?
That's got nothing to do with it, Mr. Tenderball.
Mrs. Wiggins, don't raise your voice at me.
I'll raise my voice at you if I want to, Mr. Tudball.
Okie dokie. This time you've gone too far, Mrs. Wiggins. You're a fired.
You can't fire me. I quit. You can find yourself another girl.
What's happening?
The Cracklin's what's happening?
Pop Rocks and bang to the pipe!
Pop Rocks!
The Cracklin's what's happening?
Where is she at?
Oh, Archie!
Eat it, you dingbat. Let's sing our song.
Okay.
Hide away, Glenn Miller played
songs that made the hit parade.
Guys like us, we had it made.
Those were the days. And you knew who you were then.
Guys like girls and men were men.
Mister, we could use a man like Hope and Hoover again.
Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody pulled their weight.
G.I. Road lost sour and gray. Those were the days. Thank you. Come on, eat it.
Let's hear from Matt Gumm and Katie Kohler.